This morning, eThekwini Municipality Mayor Mxolisi Kaunda briefed the media about an update with regards to cases in the province. There are 186 cases of COVID-19 confirmed here in KZN. Of that, I want to tell you that there are cases confirmed in three townships here in under the eThekwini Municipality. That is Umlazi, where I'm currently in, Kwamashu, and Amawoti, which is in Inanda. Now, Mayor Kaunda explained to us that there's one case in Kwamashu and one case in Amawoti. Of course, it's cause for concern of these cases emerging from our townships because these are congested areas. So, of course, there is a greater risk of transmission of this virus. And once, of course, more people begin catching this disease, of course, that transmission or risk of transmission further increases because of congestion of small living spaces, overcrowding spaces as well. Now, just with regards to the cases in Umlazi, I want to tell you that the first case here was of 46-year-old Tolakele Shandu. She was a teacher in Isipingo nearby. Sadly, she passed away last week. Now, we understand from this case that three others have been affected. A teacher at the school where Shandu taught at, a 14-year-old child, and another relative of Shandu. Now, of course, going forward now, tracer teams will have to interact with people here in Umlazi and find and test people as soon as they can to prevent the risk of any further transmission. This is what Mayor Mxolisi Kaunda had to say.
The areas which have been highlighted so far, because we are not allowed to deal with the statistics, we can't release statistics, but the Department of Health in the province and nationally, they released statistics indicating that we have experienced one death from Umlazi. And there are also people who are being traced and the contacts. Remember that the strategy of the department is to trace those who would have happened to be close to that person who has been found positive of this virus, as well as those who can be traced as well, who may be the potential people to contract the virus. So those are the areas, and the Umlazi, there is a case for Umlazi as well. And Etina and Amau area, where one person was also found positive in that area.
Kaunda, how has the reaction been from the locals finding out that some of them from their particular area have now contracted the virus?
Well, I just want to, in fact, show you this area behind me. We're outside the Umlazi megacity, and I want to show you the lines that is actually trying to enter the super spa here. These lines are going around the entire parking lot. There are over hundreds of people here. Now, this queue is essentially because no more than 100 people can gather inside the shop itself. But then outside the store, we're seeing, of course, no practice of social distancing. People are still close together, and then now with us hearing about, of course, the disease here in Umlazi, there is cause for concern about the risk of transmission of the virus, especially with such a large number of people. Not many people are aware of the cases here in this area right now. As we speak to them, they're of course learning for the first time about this. So now with the mayor, of course, going on with his awareness campaigns, he's been called upon to continue these campaigns, especially in areas like Umlazi, Kwamashu, and Amawoti, to go deep into those areas and explain to people the importance right now about good hygiene, social distancing, to ensure that there's no possibility of COVID-19 in this area. Currently, he's also been visiting informal settlements as well. He just visited the Glebelands Hostel in Umlazi, which is behind us. Hundreds of thousands of people live there, and of course, in very overcrowded conditions. Cause for concern again, he went there to deliver sanitary products, including hand sanitizers, soap, putting up posters and speaking to people, essentially to make them understand the importance right now about adhering to the lockdown, adhering to the regulations. This is what he had to say with regards to awareness at the hostel.
We've been engaged on the trail of activities that include cleaning of hostels in different places. There are about 11 in the city. We started immediately after the lockdown, as the president pronounced
the lockdown. We have conducted clear assessments even here at Glebelands Hostel. Our observation is that the cleanliness is being observed, as we have also seen when we're conducting our walkabouts in the area. But we are also supplying the material which is necessary for citizens to have during this period of COVID-19, the sanitizers and the soaps. We are also spreading our message to ensure that we engage committee members to understand what are the precautionary measures that they need to take to prevent the contraction of this virus. Because we've been getting some concerning news that in one of the areas like Amawotigwamashu, those townships and informal settlement, there are people who are found positive in those areas. Hence, our program is targeting all informal settlements, all hostels, all our transit camps that where people are located, to ascertain that the clean environment is provided and we supply the material that people are in dire need to have. So we are doing this because we have a clear conviction that if we can ensure that people, they observe cleanliness and the high hygiene observations, then people will be able to be saved from this virus.
Kaunda, I must say that looking behind you now, this is one of the first few cases or situations where I've seen that there is a level of social distancing that is actually being practiced in the long queues that one is finding in places around the country. But I'm particularly interested to find out about the measures that management has put in place for those who are homeless and who are in need of shelter at this time. If you could talk to us about that.
Indeed, we did raise these questions to the mayor, especially because at the start of the lockdown on Friday, many homeless people were being taken to the Durban Exhibition Centre, where they were being screened in order for them to be sent to several shelters across the city. The mayor so far has told us that at these shelters, the people who are there are being provided with food and medication. However, at some shelters, not all is calm and collected. For example, at the Albert Park shelter, people have actually torn down the shelter. They do not want it. They only want the food assistance that is being provided by the municipality and local NGOs, as well as these riots, we understand, are unfolding because of withdrawal symptoms. Sadly, many of those who are without a home and have been living on the streets of Durban have been addicted to drugs. And now, as they are trying to live in the shelter in the midst of the lockdown to be protected, they are having these withdrawal symptoms. We understand that medical treatment is being provided to some of them, but it is a very challenging time for them. Now, not all those without a home have managed to find this shelter. In areas outside of the Durban CBD, such as Overport and Chatsworth, we are still seeing people on the streets begging for food, for money, so that they can find somewhere safe to stay and some food to eat. This is because during the lockdown, of course, the regular assistance that they are provided with is not essentially there right now. So there are still challenges in ensuring that everybody who needs shelter is taken off the road. I must also tell you that the mayor has spoken out against apparent evictions of people. There were instances where structures were broken down in areas of Durban at the start of the lockdown. And we had to raise questions about this. Where would people live? We understand now that it was in that instance people were going against regulations and building temporary shelters to, of course, have people rent in those shelters. That's a cause for concern, exploiting the lockdown at this moment. And that is what the mayor's team has to deal with, to try and, of course, house those without a home, but ensure that other people on the streets are not exploiting the situation.